Hello friends, we are going for the concrete design using the BS standard code. So let's see how to design, how to analyze in a start pro. So let's start with the start pro for a concrete design using BS code. So first of all, give a new project, space, structure type, and then give a new name. So design here, and then select unit meter and kilonewton. Now press next, and then finish. In the geometry tool, paste toolbar, create a new geometry. So I am creating a new geometry here. So here we have a 2D frame, you can select it and just give a transition repeat to it. In the Z axis, click 2 and give a spacing as 4 meter, link step, open base, OK. Okay, so now let's check the elevation view. Now after that, go to the general and define the property. So I'm taking the shape as rectangle and give the size of the columns, it is 0.3 by 0.3. Now add it and go for the beam. So I'm giving the YD as 0.25 and then add it. Now assign the column first of all, select beam parallel to Y axis only and then assign and select the beam. Parallel to X axis and then Z axis, then assign. After that, go for the support. So here we have many type of support: fixed pin, fixed part, info. So for the building, we will take fixed support. So just select the fixed and add it. Now select the fixed support and in the elevation view, assign the fixed support at the node. Here we have assigned. Now go for the load and definition, select the load case detail, add it and then dead load. So now select, give the type as dead first of all and then give the type as live, add it, close. Now in the dead load, assign the self weight, then member load, so load of the wall, take it as -10. Then close it and now go for the live load, add and give the live load of the floor, so it is -2. So it is a floor type of load, so give it in the floor -2 or 3 and give the height of the building, so it is 9 meter. Now add it, close. Now you can see live load is assigned. Now once again give a dead load of the floor, so in the type floor load, give it as -3.75. suppose the floor is of 150 mm thickness. Now give the height 9 meter, again add, close. Now it is also assigned. Now assign the self weight, assign to view and then assign UDL, select and then select beam parallel to X, select beam parallel to Z and then assign it, assign to selected views, assign it. Now after that, select the load case detail option, add and go for the defined combination. You can select defined combination, auto load combination also you can select, select Indian code and then select generate load and deselect all and then select 1.5 only and then add it. So here we have defined factor of safety as 1.5. Now give the analysis command, so here it is, add, close and then analyze it, analyze, save. So it is done now. Now you can check the result. So result of the analysis are what? For the note it is displacement, then second is reaction. For the beam it is forces and then stresses here. You can select any column and check the stresses. Display lesion, display corner stresses you can check. Now next is what? Graphs. You can select any column or beam. For that you can check the graph. Then go for the animation. You can select deflection or suction displacement and you can check the displacement or the deflection here. Next is go for the modeling tab once again and select the design case toolbar. In that select concrete and then select the code as BS8007. Here it is. Now select the parameters. So here we are many parameters. First is clear cover, then second is crack limit, next is compressive strength, then yield strength of the steel, then select SCON parameter here, and then orthogonal reinforcement layout, then temperature again. So I am selecting only two, FC and FY main, then OK. Now here I am going to give the grade of the concrete. So it is 25000, it is a compressive limit at, and then next is yield limit. So here it is 415000, sorry, it is 415. And then add it. Now assign to, select assign to view option and assign it. Next go for the command, select design beam and then select design column and then close it. Now go for the design beam and then select beam parallel to X, then beam parallel to Z and then assign it. The next design column and select beam parallel to Y and then assign it. Yes. Now analyze, run analysis, save. Now check the output. Now go for the result. Here is a concrete design. Now you can see here is the result for the beam number 4. It is first layer, second layer and third. So what is first, second and third layer? Select any beam and go for the concrete design. Now you can see it is the first section, the starting, second is for the mid and third is for the ends. So in the output if you will check, so it is the first starting section, it is the second and it is the last section. End means in the starting you have to give 4 bars of 8 mm, in the mid you have to give 4 bars of 8 mm, means in the bottom reinforcement. And for the top, once again in the end, you have to provide 5 bars of 10 mm. Next is here the stirrup detail. So you can see from the end 1 up to end 2. And this is the maximum shear, here is the load, here is the length, means 8 mm length, the dia of the stirrup. And here is the spacing, and here is the number of stirrup, 6. 6 stirrup. From the first start to 750 mm length, you have to provide 6 stirrup of 8 mm with the spacing of 150 mm. And from 1749 to up to end 2, you have to provide maximum 8 mm of stirrup, total 10, and spacing is 138 mm. And same as the beam, you can sell. See the column design here. So 8 numbers of bar, 8 mm dia, and here the reinforcement percentage, and here is the area of steel required. It is 360 square meter. And if you want to check the drawing of the column, double click on it and you will get the design. So